my garage, that's my second home. You know, I don't actually live here, so I live in the garage, so. But working on, you know, working on my car, it helped me. And that's my passion, you know, my working on my little 79 Trans Am. Maybe that played a part in my recovery. I really think it did. Probably about a year ago, I started having headaches. They were pretty bad headaches, and I knew something else was wrong.
We decided to look for a neurologist here in Virginia. They decided to do another MRI, in which they did, and it actually showed the AVM. And he shared with us that it was some aneurysms there as well because of the AVM.
A brain arteriovenous malformation, or AVM for short, is an abnormal tangle of blood vessels in the brain. There are various grading classifications for these that really predict how severe they can be, or particularly how complicated the surgery can be to remove these. In William's case, he had the highest grade, which was a grade 5 AVM.
I decided to, let's go online and start looking at different doctors, different hospitals. We together did some research, typed in top 10 hospitals for brain surgery, and Hopkins was number one.
An AVM, as complicated as William's, really has many aspects that we need to deal with when thinking about how to treat this. There's the AVM itself, but also there can be other components of the AVM that make it higher risk, such as an aneurysm. Before we ever take a patient to surgery, we really want to make sure that surgery is as safe as it possibly can be. So in William's case, we brought him in several times to perform what's called an embolization, where we can close down blood supply to both the AVM as well as to aneurysms associated with an AVM. And this is all done in a minimally invasive way. It's all done through the blood vessels. We access the blood vessel in the leg, and then we're able to get all the way up to the brain and take care of something like this. And a procedure that's typically very well tolerated, and often the patient goes home the next day or the day after.
And the first procedure started in July, and the last one was in December. The major surgery was in January 12th.
So in January, William had a surgical procedure called a craniotomy, which means we made an opening in the skull to be able to get to the brain to remove the AVM. These procedures are long, tedious surgeries where we decrease the blood supply to the arteriovenous malformation, and that enables us to then resect the entire thing, really providing him a cure.
He told us what to expect once the surgery was completed, that, you know, he might not, remember some things right away. That part of the brain might affect that he couldn't talk, you know, might to the point that he couldn't think how to walk.
The surgery was successful.
He hasn't had
not one headache.
Not one headache, and actually knew who everybody was right away. The swelling went down just like it's supposed to. You know, it wasn't a long delay on that. His
hair grew back.
Yeah, hair grew back quickly.
For the most part.
Fortunately, William did very well. Despite having the highest grade AVM, or a grade 5 AVM, which really would put him at risk for having significant complications from the surgery, he did great. He spent a few days in the hospital and then went home and was able to return to his normal life.
Hopkins, just so much support and experience, and certainly fun to be able to get back to my car and continue to enjoy it as I had before the surgery. So my yard, I love my yard. Can't forget my wife. She's been great through all of this. She's really been great. To talk about support, it's, you know, I don't think I could have went through it without this woman right here. She's really been awesome, and she continues right today to support me 100%. To have her with me, it's really been good.